Without further ado, who's ready to see the room for kiddos shine? All right, they're gonna strut into this room like they've never strut before. So let's welcome room four. Oh yeah, and while they're strutting in, Positively Arts, we're a 501c3 nonprofit, and we empower kids for life. We can have some of you on this side too. You guys want to come on this side?
Yes,
yeah, let's flank them with positive energy. So we are all of, obviously it's in the name, Positively Arts. If you want to hoot and holler and scream for these kiddos, it's pretty, oh, they want to stay together. That's so cute. We love it. Just don't blow your ear out with that speaker, Violet. You're too talented to lose an ear. All right, so I don't know if anyone has ever been on stage before with the lights and stuff, but it's pretty scary. So these kids have super courage. So if you see anything you like, please don't be afraid to scream and clap and make some weird noises because they need to hear your support. Are you guys ready? Oh, she said terrified in a good way. Well, no, it's good. It's processed in the same part of your brain, fear and excitement, so you just gotta think positively. Miss Naree, who are we starting with? Drum roll.
Miss Violet!
To think of a good name for me. Oh, and does mommy give me a beautiful dress, a prince to dance with at the ball, or even a pair of glass slippers? No, all she gives me is a big, fat pile of chores. And I don't even have magic. Mommy says it skips a generation, so I can't point at my feet and hope to see a pair of glass slippers. You wanna see? Here, I'll show you. Bippity, boppity, bam! Whoa, a pair of glass slippers. Mommy was wrong. Magic doesn't skip a generation after all. That wasn't the first time for sure. Now, I wonder if that Prince Charming guy is still available. If not, there may have to be a little magical interference between that Cinderella guy, that Cinderella girl, and Prince Charming. Now, what's his number? There's a princess in a tower. Oh my gosh, that's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing, like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits. As years go by, uh-oh. A treacherous existence, I don't remember this part. She wishes she were dead, skip ahead. But in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire who's really good at climbing and braiding golden hair. And I know he'll appear, cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight, my white knight and his steed will look just like these pictures. It won't be long now, I guarantee.
performer. Show some love for Emma!
Now, we need to teach you how to be a pirate. So I'll be here to help, but you need a few tips from a real pirate first. Lesson number one, you can't be happy. Pirates are always grumpy, and if something good happens, they growl and get angry that it wasn't better. It might look like they're excited, but they're not. They're angry that it wasn't better, and they'll stay angry until all the treasures in the world are theirs. And then the anger dies down. They get grumpy again. Lesson number two, no baths, no washing, no cleaning up, and last but not least, no perfume. Pirates take pride in their stench. It's like a contest or something. And if something good happens, they just say that it's not good. Like, it's not bad. But anyways, it's also very stinky when the good smells always blend in. It's like a contest or something, and a orchestra. Lesson number, next one, you have to stop being so girly. Female pirates are the roughest, toughest, meanest human beings to ever travel to sea. If a male steals one gold, you steal two. If a male cuts off one finger, you cut off two. Be better or be dead. There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Belly of Tea. The wind blew up above, dipped down below. My boat was blue. Soon may the women come to bring us sugar, no sugar and tea and rum. One day when the sugar is done, we'll take our leave and go. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore, down on her a white whale bore. The captain called and headed toward, he'd take the whale in tow. Soon may the whale men come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tugging is done, we'll take our leave and go.
You picked a crowd favorite. Well done. All right, let's make it nice and warm for Maybe!
Grandma, can I have a snack, please? I'm so hungry because Mom took me to Toys R Us and she said I could pick out one game. So I looked and looked and then I found candy. I was so ready to go home and eat all that candy. So I tasted it, and it all just tasted like cardboard. I guess I picked out a spoiled box.
Like, I'm not an armrest. I'm a human being. When I went to the
I asked if I wanted the 12 and under ticket. 12 and under? I'm 16! People always taunt you by holding something above your head or putting it on a high shelf. I wish I could strangle each and every tall person. But to do so, I would need a stepladder. I stay up too late. Got nothing in my brain. That's what people say. Pigtails and sticks it in and sucks it out of her hair. It's disgusting.
Tell Jack I'll see him later then. I have to go home and eat a few hot dogs. I think it's a 3 hot dog day.
Thank you.
what we call teamwork. Give it up for their instructor, Miss Naree. And Miss Lily, we miss you, Miss Lily. She had a gig tonight. Big bow, arms up. Yes, we're gonna hear from all of you. So Miss Naree, you're in charge of swabbing. So if you haven't noticed, at Positively Arts, we are all about creating a culture of kindness and support, and I think these kiddos got an A+ in that department. So we wanted to take some time to ask all of them, what was your favorite part of the last 2 weeks? And we'll start with Miss Violet. You can be my swabber.
Okay, first of all, I would like to say something. Thank you, Miss Lily. She's not out here right now because she's Elsa right now.
Yeah.
Also, my favorite part of the last 2 weeks was how like everybody bonded and we like all the songs were like super funny and like I couldn't stop laughing this like entire 2 weeks. Yeah.
That's a good reason. All right, next. Ryan, what was your favorite part?
That how we sing songs together and games.
Songs and games. And you guys made little bracelets or something, right?
We made lizards.
You made lizards. That's even cooler.
All right.
Yane, what's the favorite part of the last 2 weeks for you?
I like when our friend Scarlett was here that we couldn't stop saying Material Girl. First few days, it was like the new trend. Like nobody could stop saying it. And then the two boys in the class, we called them Material Boys.
Let's give a shout out to Scarlett because she wishes she could be here. Hi, Scarlett, we miss you. What was your favorite part?
Everything.
Thanks, Mimi. Right, Emma. Favorite part?
My favorite part was how we spend time together on our puppets.
Yeah?
Oh, I love that. We're going to scooch down and give them some room. Their puppet show was really good, you guys. Like, we'll send more videos when we have time to download them. Okay.
My favorite part that we just all bonded together and it was really fun. We played games and we made trends.
What was your favorite game?
Making movies.
Yes!
So, Miss Naree put on music, like music, and we had to write what we thought it felt like in our journals, and all of us made like full-on movies.
Yeah.
Amazing! We love making your own media. Don't forget to collect your happy notes. Did you guys all get your happy notes? So a signature part of all of our programs is we like to talk about feelings and validate each other. So they all took the time to write positive notes of affirmation to one another, and they're called happy notes, and they're upstairs. All right, last but not least, let's see, what was your favorite part?
I loved making new friends, and we would constantly break out into random songs. Like every single 5 minutes, pretty much.
I love that. All right, we're going to open it up to the crowd. Do you guys have any questions for these superstars? Anyone? Anyone?
What do you want to be when you grow up?
What do you want to be when you grow up? And just yell it out.
Actor, comedian. Definitely an actor.
Scientist.
I love it. Any other questions for these superstars? What was your question? Material Girl. Miss Naree has a question.
What's your favorite One Direction song that we played?
That's a hard one, isn't it?
Yes! Yeah,
One Direction.
It's a
no-brainer!
You
sing it.
Play One Direction.
Yeah.
Where were you?
Oh, the One Direction Wellerman song.
Yes. Yes.
Sing it.
Yeah. Sing it. The answer is what makes you beautiful.
What makes you beautiful? All right, let's get one more. Arms up, everyone, arms up, and take your fancy bow, however you like, whatever bow you like. Thank you. thank you so much for coming and watch Room 4. We're going to turn the lights on so you can take photos with our photo wall. Thank you so much, everybody. We miss you, Miss Lily and Scarlett. So this is what we did with a group of kids over the summer for the same class. So enjoy while I'm stalling for the kids to get ready upstairs. Here we go. So what you just saw were clips. We made 15 original music videos and web series. Someone made their own documentary. So if you would like your kid to do the Make Your Own Media class, we're offering it on several different days. We'll send you our schedule. We have classes weekdays from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. right here, or on the weekends, Saturdays and Sundays. The kids had a blast. So a lot of them wrote their own original stuff. That was one of our original songs, and they just wanted to sing it. So it's a super fun class. It gets them thinking, and we teach them all these wonderful life skills. We love project-based learning.